saga or romance, whether true or fabricated, whether planned or happenstance. They're sweeping through the ages, casting centuries aside. Or a hurried, brief recital, just a 30-minute ride. Whether bright or melancholy, rough and ready, finally spun.
Thank you. edge, you must have a burning desire to see Egypt. Have you finished the map?
Yes, Captain.
Good work, but this is wrong. From the mast, it looked like it curved to the north. Like this, let me show you.
My sword! My sword!
Release them!
Hand it over. Now!
You took us from Nubia, and now you say we belong to you, yes?
Yes.
Well, I took this soldier from your ranks, so by your own logic, he belongs to me. Now let them go!
Throw her in the river!
No. I have a better plan for her.
Don't.
You don't want me to remove your shackles? They'll only get in the way. Very impressive up there. I should enlist you in my army. Make you my lieutenant.
Are you mocking me, Captain?
No, admiring you. You know what's going to happen now? You're going to scrub the filth of battle from my skin. It's been a long time since I felt clean. You know, you're much better with a sword than you are with a sponge.
I wish I had a sword now.
There's mine. Help yourself. Who taught you to use a weapon?
My father.
Because he knows that Nubian men can't protect their women. You're not finished.
Yes, I am.
On your knees! You enjoy living dangerously, don't you?
About as much as I enjoy washing your filthy Egyptian skin!
You!
No! You know nothing about me! And care even less! How could you understand our emptiness? You plundered our wisdom, our knowledge, our wealth. That you will never possess. The past is now another land, far beyond my reach, invaded by insidious foreign bodies, foreign speech, where the timeless joys of childhood lie broken on the beach.
What's your name?
Aida. Please, leave them off.
You're a slave now, and if you want to survive, you better remember it.
Thank you. have the gold.
Mareb!
Master, I'm so glad you've returned.
Have you kept my house in order?
Yeah. Well, except for a few casks of wine which have mysteriously disappeared.
Again?
Here you are, my son. Home at last. Step aside, Mareb.
Yes, O Chief Minister Zoser. Loved by the people, the gods, and himself.
Careful, boy.
It's good to see you, Father.
You were gone for so long. I was beginning to worry. You weren't injured in battle?
No.
I kept telling the princess that no man could best you with a sword.
No man got the better of me. Though a certain woman might have.
Really?
Listen, beyond the fifth cataract, the Nile heads directly towards Khartoum.
Then we can attack the city via water. Excellent. You recorded the landscape?
With the maps we made, an illiterate foot soldier could find his way through Nubia.
And you brought us captives. Good. Take them to the copper mines. They can't seem to keep them alive down there.
Stop! Not this one. I need a gift for the princess.
Yes, she'd be expecting something.
Take the others down to the palace groundskeeper. They can help with the harvest. They're all women. They wouldn't last a day underground.
As you wish. They're your slaves.
Thank you.
Give me your hands, Aida.
Your name is Aida.
Mareb! You dare try to escape. I will come after you myself.
You flatter me, Captain. You don't look like a man who would chase after any woman.
I'll make an exception for you. Mareb!
Yes, Captain?
Take her to Princess Amneris with my compliments.
You've been gone for 6 months. I really think a personal appearance is in order.
In good time, Father. In good time. Though you and the princess should know that as soon as my crew is rested, I am setting out again.
You can't! Right away, Egypt needs you now. There is not the powerful leader. He was when you left. While you've been away, cavorting, matters here have moved apace. And I need you home, supporting all the plans I put in place. First of all, this means your wedding. You recall your future bride. For the way the Pharaoh's heading, time's no longer on our side. According to the high God Horus, almost regal in the land, it's not that much longer for us to build another pyramid.
You mean Pharaoh's fallen ill? Is it serious?
I'm afraid so.
I must go to him.
Yes, that's to bring him some comfort. See you tonight at the banquet, Captain.
There are many who will be tearful as our little fades away. But our architects are cheerful, and each dog must have its day. If our country is to flourish, then my son must take a lead. Be our inspiration nourish, all our hopes, our dreams, our creed. Soon our modern rapper fills the tomb, just like his father's dead. Summons Egypt's greatest builders, builds another piece.
Build it, another pyramid.
There will be a time for mourning, but for now the plan's on hold.
Oh!
But I give the nation warning that before the corpse is cold,
gold
will extend fair Egypt's power, Egypt's glory, strength and style. We shall have our finest hour far beyond the mighty now. He must have a force to swim by, and he stands his door to lid. 5,000 slaves on standby to build another pyramid.
Build it, build it. Build it, build it. Build it, build it. Build it. Build it, build it, build it.
Too much. We don't want him dying. Just yet.
Well, now you look like a handmaiden. But at least the captain saw that you were special.
What that man sees and understands could be etched on a grain of sand.
That may be. But Radames did save you and the other women from the copper mines.
That was surprising and decent of him.
When I was 10, Radames saved me from being beaten to death by a palace guard. He promised he'd look after me from then on, and he kept that promise. Look, I know what you're thinking, that I've become one of them, but I am Nubian. I will always be Nubian.
Of course.
I grew up in your hometown. At least began to grow. I hadn't got to my first shave before the body blow. Egyptians in the courtyard, my family in chains. You witnessed a reproduction, which possibly explains how I know you. How I know you. Before that fateful morning, my family enjoyed a privileged existence, for my father was employed as advisor to the king, no less, which surely rings a bell. As you are his daughter, you probably can tell how I know you. Yes, I know you. Of hope for freedom, no terror can subdue.
My only hope is silence. You've never seen my face.
No, you remain a princess in any time or place.
You don't know me.
Yes, I know you.
You must treat me like any other slave. If the Egyptians knew I was the daughter of the Nubian king, they
would kill you. But our people will keep your secret.
No! You mustn't tell anyone who I am. From now on, I am nothing but a gift from an Egyptian captain to his princess.
Just so you know, Amneris is more than that to Radames. She's his betrothed.
He's to be married? When?
The day's ship sinks, and the royal builders refuse to make him another. Come, let's get you to the princess.
Such hard work maintaining perfection. What's worth the effort, don't you think? Really perfect, really. Then maybe one of you can explain to me why Radames, the man destined to be my one and only, is neglecting me. He's been to see my father. I hear he spent time with his father. In fact, he's probably chummed it up with every withered old man in Egypt, but clearly the thought of visiting a young ripe princess with fabulous hair leaves him cold.
Princess Amneris, first in beauty, wisdom, and accessories. The captain has not forgotten you. He knows you will be at the feast tonight in all your extravagant finery, and he can hardly wait. But for now, he sends you this gift.
Another handmaiden? I don't need another handmaiden. Does this gift have a name?
Aida.
Did he just speak?
My name is Aida, princess, and I thought you might...
How dare you! You do not tremble, you do not lower your eyes. Are you not afraid of me?
Would it please you if I were?
Not so much.
Then I'm doing as you please.
True, that's true. You started to say something about...
Captain Radames.
What do you know of the captain?
Only that he is well. He suffered no injuries in battle. I thought you might wish to know that.
I did. You see, I've been so... You're very astute, aren't you, Aida?
Only on occasion. But my true talent lies with a needle. And if you will allow me, princess, I will make you a robe in a shade closer to that of your eyes. There's a dyeing process I use that makes fabrics glow. It's a secret that was passed down by the handmaidens of Queen Nefertiti.
A slave? Who knows her fabrics? I'm keeping her. Oh, Radames, he knows me. He really, really knows me. Go, Mare, show Aida the sewing room. All right, ladies, let's polish this gem. In life, one has to face a huge assortment of nauseating facts and good advice. There's health and fitness, diet and deportment, and other pointless forms of sacrifice. Conversation, wit, I am a doubter. Manners, charm, they're no way to impress. So forget the enemy, observe the outer. I am what I wear and how I dress. Whether polka dot is striped or even checked, with some demo guarantee in every fiber of my being,
Ida managed to make herself indispensable in record time.
I'm not surprised. Did she tell you anything about herself? Because I've never met a woman like her before, and I can't help but wonder...
No, nothing. She said nothing.
You look lovely tonight.
Thank you.
Is this the latest fashion?
It is now. So your expedition went well?
Oh yes. We got well past Aswan, into territory where no Egyptian has ever set foot.
That sounds very scenic. Maybe next time I'll go with you?
If you like, princess. We sleep with sand mites, live on dried monkey meat, and this time the water was so tainted, we vomited for days.
Phew! Then again, I'm pretty busy.
Princess, the word of your arrival has spread to the Nubian camp. Your people cannot wait to see you. Welcome, welcome.
Mareb!
Okay, so I told one person, maybe two. Princess, your people need to know.
Captain, to a successful expedition, thanks to the routes that you have discovered, our troops will now be able to attack Nubia with overwhelming force. The gods willing, this war shall soon come to an end, with Egypt's complete and final victory. Amneris, shall I continue?
Whatever you think is best, father.
Radames, you came to me this morning with a request to set out on another journey. However, I have a more important mission for you. Though it means that you can never leave Egyptian soil again, I believe this will be a joyous assignment. One I would only trust to a man who I've long regarded as a member of my own family.
It has been a privilege to serve you, Your Majesty.
As you all know, Captain Radames and my daughter have been betrothed for 9 years now. Long enough, I'd say. I want to see her and the nation happily settled before I leave this earth. Therefore, in 7 days, Radames, son of Zosa, shall wed the princess Amneris. The son of Isis has spoken.
I'd known such an awkward young girl turned into a stunning woman. I would have offered for her myself.
It's not too late.
I thought you loved him, Amneris.
Of course I do. We grew up together.
Then what is it? Radames, I've spent years working towards this day. You are not ruining this. Not for yourself or me. Welcome to your new life, son.
Nothing is an accident. We are free to have it all. We are what we want to be. It's in ourselves to write for. This is easy to believe when this place is called to me. Harder from the palace yard. Fortune favors the free.
No. Stay.
Yes, Captain?
Where are you from?
Ikaita. It's a village near
the second cataract. The river's an entirely different color there.
No, it's an entirely different color here.
Fair enough.
My father and I used to spend days sailing the Nile. He'd let me choose the course, and sometimes I'd even run us aground on purpose, whenever there was something I wanted to see on the shore.
Did you ever sail north?
No. My father felt the first cataract, being so close to the borders of Egypt, was too... was too dangerous a place to take me.
But there are no Egyptians in the first cataract. Only these tiny grassy islands. And the sunlight is different there. In Egypt it is harsh and direct, but there it shimmers. It's the most beautiful place I've ever seen.
Of course. It's Nubia. I would like to see that part of my country.
To sail away to half-discovered places, to see the secrets of few eyes have seen, to see moments of enchantment on our faces, the moments when we smile and those between.
Are you talking about Nubia now?
Yes. No way.
If I could leave this place, I would sail to corners of my land where there would be sweet southern winds of liberty prevailing, a beauty so majestic and so free.
I will take you sailing south. You can be my guide.
Let me steer.
Would you run us aground?
Oh, yes. Wherever there are no people, I jump out of the boat, kick off my sandals, and run. And there'd be no one there to scold me and tell me to behave like a good... Well, to behave.
Fortunes far behind me.
I put my faith and trust in something new.
Why did I tell you this?
A stranger I've just met.
A woman whom I hardly know at all and should forget.
A journey we can only dream of. Did I say these things so easily to you?
This is meaningless. I will never take you sailing. I'm never going to leave Egypt again. Instead, I'll sit on the throne and send other men off on their expeditions.
You talk as though you've been enslaved.
No, with no chains, maybe. Or the marriage promise. What is that for?
To dry my weeping eyes. Forced to marry a princess. Oh, what hardships. I know. You want to go to lands where people have been living for centuries and say that you discovered them. But instead, you're being thrust onto the Pharaoh's throne. It is a great tragedy.
You go too far.
No, you go too far. If you don't like your fate, change it. You are your own master. There are no shackles on you. So don't expect any pity or understanding from this humble palace slave.
Stop. I command you to stop.
I hardly know at all and should forget. Anonymous and gone tomorrow. Enchantment passing through. All I've done is tell her things that she already knew.
Let me. How is your father?
I don't get it. This illness of his came on so suddenly. Weeks ago he was healthy, and the court physicians, they have no idea what it is. It was a magnificent feast, though, wasn't it?
Yes, princess.
Oh, there's so much to do to get ready for the wedding ceremony. From the bronze entry statue of me, to the centerpieces of lilies and roses arranged to look like me.
It must be difficult.
Planning a wedding?
No, being a princess.
Oh, you have no idea. The responsibilities are overwhelming.
Your people must expect so much.
They want a goddess, and I'm just
human.
I may leave a great impression as I race through a succession of the latest crazes, chase the newest fad. I feel better when beguiling, find that fashion keeps me smiling. But in my heart, I know it's rather sad that a life of great potential is dismissed inconsequential and only ever seen as being cute. So I'll flutter to deceive.
Oh no, no, you must believe that one day you're bound to find a stronger suit.
Radames, this is my dressing room. You can't just, you know, you shouldn't. Aida, leave.
No, stay. Pour the princess a cup of wine.
Are you trying to get me drunk, Radames? You know it's not necessary.
Is that our supper in there?
Honey covered and loaded with treats.
Why don't you go in and I'll join you in a moment. Do you think you can speak to me like that? Scold me like a shrew and then walk away? You forget that I can have you carried off to the copper mines.
And you forget that I am her property now, not yours.
Well, it doesn't matter. Because I know now that you were right. What?
I'm shocked. Even in enlightened Nubia, one never hears a man admit he's wrong.
Radames, supper's ready.
I'll be right in, princess. Aida, I was wrong. And I have been selfish. If Pharaoh does not recover, Egypt is going to need a new leader. A strong leader. And I don't think that's Amneris.
Radames, your engagement supper is ready.
You should go to her.
Were you a noble woman before you were captured?
What does it matter? There's nothing noble about me now.
You're wrong. You are noble. Very few of us dare to speak so honestly. And considering you're a slave.
Yes, we mustn't ever forget that I'm a slave.
I cannot take back the past, Aida. But even if I could, I don't think I want to. Aida, I...
Radames! You barge into my quarters, waging a full-frontal attack, so to speak, and now you're stalling? Why?
I'm sorry. I didn't realize.
There's a delicious supper with a divine princess waiting for you. What exactly didn't you realize? Unless you would prefer some of that dried monkey meat and rotting water, Captain, then maybe you'll be more inclined to be romantic. Was it something I said? When we were children, we understood each other so well. Now he's just a mystery to me.
Aida, there you are. Will you come with me?
Where?
To the Nubian camp. Look, people know I'm the one who can get things. And our people, they've asked me to bring them you.
Why? So they can see a reckless fool dressed as a servant? No, that is what I am, Mareb. My father told me not to leave the boundaries of our village, but I could not be so constrained. I took Nehebka and the other women up the river. I had to see the countryside. And that's where the Egyptians captured us. I deserve this. And our people deserves a leader who thinks of them, not of her own selfish pleasures.
Aida, the Nubians want their princess.
It's knowing what they want of me that scares me. It's knowing, having followed, that I must lead. It's knowing that each person there compares me to those in my past who might now succeed. But how can whatever I do for them now be not enough?
of service, wisdom, courage, to us more. With these selfish, but nothing less will do. Arriva, arriva.
Again. All week your eyes have been on me.
What do you mean?
You think you're going to gain your freedom just because you've gained my attention? You are beautiful, but I'm not so easily led.
If I've looked in your direction, it was only to see if your chalice needed refilling.
I have no chalice now, and yet you're looking.
Excuse me, Captain, but I have linen to wash.
I do not excuse you. Stop there.
You wanted something from me?
Yes. I want to make your life easier, Aida. Tell me how. What can I do for you?
Help my people.
I want to help you.
I am my people. And I cannot continue to live in the comfort of the palace while my countrymen are dying. You want my affection, Captain?
I can have your affection right here if I command it. I just want to know if you feel anything for me. Aside from Pizza.
I don't know.
Well, then let's find out.
Aida! I just saw... Aida, Anaris requests your presence. The princess. Your betrothed.
Certain grounds, a picture of true happiness, a confidence so effortless, no brighter could be found. Oh no, I never asked the questions that trouble me today. I knew all there was to know. Love worn lightly, put on show, my conquest on display.
I can't believe he's changing.
Who'd have thought that confidence could die?
Oh no,
not me,
not me,
not me,
not me.
That all I took for granted was a lie.
Oh no,
not me,
not me,
not me. I throw my world away to be with someone I'm afraid will say not me.
This can never be.
Not me.
He's in love, but he's not the only one who'll be changed.
This would look lovely on you. I'll say this for you, Egyptians. Your thread count is amazing.
We made it 3 days, and yet, Aida, I must make things right with him.
I shall not envy lovers, but long for what they share. An empty room is merciless. Don't be surprised if I confess.
Where did you get that?
The Egyptian captain. He's giving away everything he owns. And he's giving it all to us.
And who'd have guessed he threw his world away to be with someone till he died? Then not me.
Whatever doubts he had the other night must be gone. But you stay, Aida. Apologize for it.
Oh, no, I can't.
Please, you always say the right thing. I never do.
No, please, princess. Don't make me.
I would never make you. But I'm asking you as my friend.
Thank you.
Nothing. Actually, it was everything. But it doesn't matter.
Captain, I just came to tell you that the princess is sorry for what she said the other night. and she wants you to know that you are betrothed to my mistress.
It was arranged by my father. It will be unarranged by me.
You could raid another country tomorrow and rebuild your fortune. Radames, you're an Egyptian. And nothing can ever change that fact. I don't even know why you bothered to do this.
Don't you?
We all need such elaborate lies, wild ambitions in our sights. How unfair of the heart survives days apart and hurried night seems quite unbelievable to me. I don't want to live like that. Seems quite unbelievable to me. I don't want to love like that. I just want a time to be slower and gentler, wiser, free. We all live in extravagant times, playing games we can't all win. Unintended emotional crime stakes them out, take others in. I'm so tired of all we're going through. I don't want to live like that. I'm so tired of all we're going through. I don't want to love that. I just wanna be with you now and forever. Peaceful, true. This may not be the moment to tell you face to face, but I could wait forever for the perfect time and place. Lies. We don't know whose words are true. Strangers, lovers, husbands, wives. Hard to know who's loving who.
Too many choices tear us apart.
Back to the palace. You'll be safe there. Wait. Take my amulet. If anyone stops you, show them this and they let you pass.
I
love you.
I heard that. Say it again. I command you to say it again. I heard the drums.
But I've captured the Nubian king.
The king? You've taken him alive. Find out which men are responsible for this. I'll see they receive the highest honors. Tell the others I'm on my way.
Yes, Captain.
Aida, our country's at war. I can't change that.
But he's my king. Not true!
I saw our king dragged through the streets with my own eyes.
I heard he's been executed.
And they are carrying his head through the street on the end of a spike.
No, no, no!
Amonasro is alive. I saw him taken to the prison.
But it's only a matter of time before the Egyptians slaughter him.
I always thought that your father would march upon Egypt in triumph. But now, we have no hope. When your father dies, so does Nubia.
Nubia will never die. Whether we are enslaved, or whether we are far from our native soil, Nubia lives on in our hearts, and therefore it lives.
Take me in, my dreams recurring, cheerful as a childhood dance, into one more taste of freedom, one more longing, backward glance. In the sway of somber music, I shall never, never understand. Let me sleep. Chorus of that other land. God's love, Nubia, the beautiful, the golden, the radiant, the fertile, the gentle and the blessed. The pain of Nubia is only of the moment, the desolate.
Across the harvest field.
stop thinking what I'm thinking. Always have to step behind. Always have to step behind. Oh, 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 oh.
Every kind of trouble, can't you tell? Just look at me. Half ecstatic, half dejected. All in all, I'm all at sea. Easy terms I thought I wanted. Fill me now with chill and dread. You can never know the chaos of a life turned on its head. Of a life turned on its head. Oh.
Could be his life companion anywhere but where we are. Am I leader? Am I traitor? Did I take a step too far? Did I take a step too far?
Every kind of trouble.
Myself to believe anything else.
Have they mistreated you?
No. I believe they're saving that part for my execution. 3 days from now.
It won't come to that. We'll get you out of here.
In 2 days, the daughter of the pharaoh will be wed. Most of the guards will be needed to control the crowds.
And who is this young minister of war?
This is Mareb. You remember? Hennu's boy.
Hennu. Your father was a great warrior. He had hopes that he'd grow up to be a scholar.
The chief jailer will be attending Amneris' wedding. They've assigned a lowly guard to take his place. A man I know.
Are you suggesting you may be able to bribe this guard?
Let's just say we've done business in the past.
That would take a lot of gold.
I have it. For years I've been stealing from the palace, in hopes that one day maybe I could use it to go back to Nubia. But if I can send my king home...
We will all be going home soon, Mareb. Now, how are the dogs guarded?
By the captain's soldiers.
So the odds are slim. Can you use a sword, boy?
Me? I'm better at providing encouragement from the sidelines.
A fight won't be necessary. They'll let us through.
Captain Radames gave you that?
Who's this captain? An Egyptian?
Yes, but he's not like the others, Father.
He leads Pharaoh's army, and he did not lay waste to our country like the others?
He regrets his past.
Aida!
Do not shame yourself with worthless sentiment. Do not tell me that this Egyptian grieves for the Nubian men executed, the women ravaged, and the children taken into slavery. Any soft look you've given to this captain, any soft word, betrays the innocence who suffered at his hands and at the hands of every soldier he commands. You will cut this man from your heart.
Yes, father.
I would not have thought it possible that these Egyptians could give me one more reason to hate them.
This is the moment when the gods expect me to beg for help, but I won't even try. I want nothing in the world but myself to protect me, and I won't lie down. Roll over and die. All I have to do is forget how much I love him. All I have to do is put my longing to one side. Tell myself that love's an ever-changing situation. Passion would have cooled and all the magic would have died. It's easy, easy. All I have to do is pretend I never knew him. On those very rare occasions when he steals into my heart, better to have lost him when the ties were barely binding. Better the contempt of the familiar cannot stop. It's easy, it's easy. Until I think about him as he was when I last touched him, and how he would have been were I to be with him today. Those very rare occasions don't let up, they keep on coming. All I ever wanted, and I'm throwing it away. Thank you.
waterways, the rest of the world opens up for us.
But our Egyptian armies just stormed in and seized power? How oppressive of us.
Perhaps, princess, where do you think that beautiful necklace came from?
Suddenly, it's not so beautiful.
You summoned me, father? Princess?
I was explaining our foreign campaigns to Mneris.
Really?
She wanted to know what's preoccupying you of late.
Radames, I feel like we haven't had a moment alone since you returned from Nubia. I miss you. Can we spend this afternoon together?
Of course we can. But first I'd like to have a word with my father. Here, read this while you wait.
The campaign at Kadesh?
It will give us something to talk about.
I didn't realize we were at loss for topics. But then there's a lot I haven't realized.
That was clever of you.
Right, Maze. I can't have you neglecting this girl. Not after all the trouble I've gone to.
You arranged a wedding.
There have been other arrangements as well. Things I've done on your behalf.
I haven't asked you to do anything for me.
You're right. You haven't, because you've been too busy whiling away the hours with that slave whore.
Your spies are good.
Radames, you can have your little diversion. Just wait after you've wed.
Like you did?
Your mother never had any complaints.
She never had a choice.
Don't you think that whore could cost you the throne?
I don't care about the throne, father, because I'm not like you, and I never will be.
My father, my son, my father, my son.
Don't come and don't touch a boy. You can't escape your genes. There's no point in feeling pure, boy. Your background intervenes. Now listen good and listen straight. You're not the master of your fate. To this you must be reconciled. You always be your father's child. The time's clean, the time's revived. But I'm doing this as I have done. Like father, like son.
Get handed down the line. Let a parent's blood suffice to condemn the child's design. I thought wrong, I can't deny. But at least I know that I shouldn't blame that on my sloth. What this may come is quite a shock. I'm no chip off in the block. I wouldn't wish those words on anyone. Like father, like son.
Son, you're nervous, take my hand. All this is settled, all this planned. You got the world at your command. I don't think you understand. Do you really want to throw your future away? Or for some wretched slave?
She has a name!
In a few months, you won't be able to remember her name.
I appreciate too well the squalor at which you sell. It isn't very hard to tell. Evil's a distinctive smell.
You can forget about your plans, father. There will be no wedding.
He's lost all sense of reason. Some foreign sight. Not only is that treason, some don't let me try. Not sight means about that flesh. Can't excite, but well a mesh. Once we get rid of this light, once the hollow's out of sight, and then I'll take the season like. He won't fall back to daddy, he will run. Like father, like son, like father, like son, like father, like son, like father, like.
find that slave girl called Aida. And when you do, kill her.
Sorry for everything I've said and for anything I forgot to say too. When things get so complicated, I'll stumble at best, muddle through. I wish that our lives could be simple. I don't want the world, only you. Oh, I wish I could tell you this face to face, but there's never the time, never the place. So this letter will have to do. I love.
Tomorrow, Princess, you and your father will be free.
We will live to tell our grandchildren of the king's great escape.
Nubia will prevail.
Yay!
Quiet!
We have come for Aida. Which one is she?
I am Aida.
Princess, but you cannot be sacrificed. Anyone here would risk their life for Nubia.
Going. You're going to meet him, aren't you?
Mareb, I do not ask you to understand. I do not understand. I must meet
no.
him. No! But I do! I have to see him.
No, you cannot give yourself to him. The Egyptians have taken enough from us already. You're our princess, our inspiration, our hope for a new day.
I'm sorry, Mareb.
There is a time, there is a place when love should conquer all. The rest of life is pushed aside as truth and reason fall. But only if that selfishness can lead to something good. I thought I knew you, princess, but I never understood. I don't know you. I don't know you.
Thank you.
thought you were...
They came for me, but they took another. I blame myself.
No, I put you in danger. But I promise it will never happen again. I'm calling off the wedding. I will build you a house on the borders of our country. And we will sail the Nile.
Oh, Bradamese! No, you can't call off the wedding.
Yes, I can and I will.
I love you, Radames, but you must marry the princess tomorrow. Tomorrow, what you want for us is impossible. They would hunt us down. It is a foolish plan.
I am here to tell you we can never meet again. Simple, really, isn't it? A word or two.
I need not reply. Every moment of my life, from now on till I die, I will think and dream of you and fail to understand how a perfect love can be confounded out of hand. Is it written in the stars? Are we paying for some crime? Is that all that we are good for? Just a stretch of mortal time, or some God's experiment in which we have no say, in which we give him paradise, but only for a day.
Marry the princess, Radames. You can help my people. This could be our chance to do something important. Don't you see? It may be the whole reason we met.
It would be a cool trick.
Not if the gods put us together for some greater purpose.
Nothing can be altered. There is nothing to decide. No escape, no change of heart, nor any place to hide.
Oh, you are all I ever want, but this I am denied. Sometimes in my darkest thoughts, I wish I never learned what it is to be in love and have that love return.
Is it written in the stars? Are we paying for some crime? Is that all that we are good for? Just some stretch of mortal time,
or some God's experiment
in which we have no say, but only for a day.
Oh, do what you ask for. But you must do something for me. Go home. Leave Egypt forever.
What are you saying?
While I'm taking my wedding vows, there will be a boat waiting for you to take you back to Nubia. At least I'll have a message of happiness knowing you're free.
I try to blame it all for just
do I want him still? Why, when there's nothing there, how to go on with the rest of my life to pretend I don't care? This should've been my time. It's over, it never began. I closed my eyes to so much for so long, and I no longer care. I tried to blame it on fortune, some kind of
Daenerys, I never meant to hurt you.
Radames, if you deny everything, there's still a chance. My father might spare your life. Listen to me, they want to bury you alive.
Yes, that's what we do to traitors.
You must say that everyone is wrong and that...
No, I can't. Aida is everything I thought I was meant to be. Her courage and her love for her people put me to shame. Every act of my life has been wrong, except for this.
Did you ever love me at all?
Nurse, I loved you all my life.
Take your hands off her. After all, she is a princess.
Daenerys, there were so many times when I wanted to tell you everything, but I couldn't.
No wonder you understood me so well.
Daenerys, you must believe me. I am to blame for what happened, not Radames. Please, Daenerys, let him live.
I can't.
Yes, you can. You love him. Don't you love him?
Daenerys, let us begin. Bring forth the prisoners! Zoser has been apprehended, and we have uncovered this plot. Radames, I chose you! I trusted your father! Now, I'll make things right, while I still can. The criminals shall receive their sentences!
Father, I have a request.
A request?
I know the traitors must die for the crimes against Egypt. This is the law. But I would ask that they be buried together.
But that would be mercy! After disgrace in front of the entire nation!
I was wronged. It should be my decision.
Amneris, you do not know your mind. For the crimes, the traitors...
Your Majesty! You have poison in your blood. We both know this. Soon I will be completely alone because everyone I love will be gone. You have to let me exercise my will over Egypt, because I am to be your successor, and because I demand it. For their crimes, the traitors will be buried beneath the sands of Egypt, in one tomb, together. The daughter of Isis has spoken.
Such elaborate lies, wild ambitions in our sights, how an affair of the heart survives days apart. I don't want to live like that. Seems quite unbelievable to me. I don't want to love like that. I just want our time to be slower and gentler, wiser, free.
Many choices.
dark.
Give me your hands. I'm right here with you. There's another world waiting for us. I can feel it. Just like I always knew there was a world beyond every bend in the Nile, just waiting to be discovered.
You will find me in that world?
I have to search 100 lifetimes. I will find you.
Thank you. ladies and gentlemen, may we have one more round of applause for these amazing young men and women. From a very young age, I have adored attending theatrical productions, especially musical theater. When we began to think of how to honor the 25th anniversary and AIDA was presented as a possibility, I jumped at the idea. I was encouraged by the look of excitement in Jonathan Todd's and Daniel Tomlin's eyes. We YouTubed Broadway productions and investigated school-appropriate versions of the musical and bought the license to produce the show from the U.S. Then Jonathan showed me his vision of the stage design, the shape of the Eye of Horus, with colors to depict the topography of Egypt, including the Nile. The actual MES Cairo production, however, was beyond my wildest expectations. I couldn't be happier and prouder. Well done. I realize it's cold, and this is the third and final show after a very busy week filled with long hours and hard work. However, we cannot end this wonderful experience without acknowledging all the wonderful people who have made this evening and the past two nights possible. Please keep your applause to the end if you can. For all the wonderful, elaborate, creative costumes, Shaima Farou for the implementation and Rosie Gonzalez for a role as costume manager. To all the teaching staff and members of the senior leadership team who helped with hair, makeup, and general supervision. For a program more artistic than the West End and certainly as professional for the wonderful and for the wonderful tickets, Susie Sheehan, Muhammad Ali, and Carol Boswell. My wonderful dedicated administrative staff who organized the front of house planning and the logistical implementation of various aspects that have helped beyond words. Without the art and props, the stage would have been colorless and gray. The work that goes into it is spectacular and varied. The art team, who implemented all the beautiful, colorful designs you see, including the props, are Lee Simpson, Kim Tapsell, Lee Hedges, Ben Myers, Lamia Afifi, Aya Abdurrahman, Muhammad the Carpenter, and believe me, I don't know his last name, Ben Higgs, Doug Walker, Haykel from primary, Malak Shazli, and Shaima Atiya. Coordinating the art as a whole, Lee Simpson, and prop manager, Fred Jabot. For the spectacular and breathtaking lighting, Yasser Sha'alan and his crew. For sound that is both professional and resourceful, Mahmoud Omar and his crew, Andy Cottle and Nader Rafat, Karim Shaltoud for technical sound, our very own Ihab and Michael. Starting this Saturday, AIDA will be streaming on our school website. This will be made possible by Muhammad Hamid and his team, and of course, photography by Adil Shafiq and the very special talents of my own brother, Tawfiq Dajani. Dressed in black and providing the angelic singing, the choir totaling more than 110 wonderfully patient student performers, rivaling the West End and Broadway. Primary led by Adam Briggs and Don Lovick, secondary led by Daniel Tomlin. Putting together this production has been difficult and a visionary chore. Jonathan Todd placed my name as producer, and for this honor I thank him, but it would not have been possible without our very own Tamer Hussein and the ever-resourceful Mr. Ayman Nassar and his team, including our alum Hadir Nassar. Aided by the dedicated team of Clement, Saeed, Muhammad, and their staff. No stranger to MES Productions, Mrs. Carol Godfrey reprises her successful role as primary coordinator as well as choreography. James Coley, for stage manager, has managed to coordinate a dedicated and loyal team of students who made the various scenes on stage possible, assisted by Omar Saeed and Saif Abdullah in their roles as assistant stage managers. At this point, I am hoping that the young men and women who work so hard backstage with costumes and in the dark with sets are on stage. Are you on stage? If not, please join us. They are. I would like to take this moment to thank Mrs. Sousan Dajani. From the very first West End production of Annie she took me to when I was just 5 years old, till this day, It has been her unwavering support and encouragement of the performing arts that has kept us all going. And here I also must mention Mr. Peter Godfrey, whose infectious love for the theater has motivated us over the years. Every year he presents me with a list of plays he has booked for us to see together in the West End. His enthusiasm and sheer intuitive talent is inspirational. To our enormously multi-talented musical director, Daniel Tomlin. What this man can do with a twirling flag is spectacular. It is only overshadowed by his magic with music and how he inspires his students. Scores and musical notes are second nature to him, and he has infected all of us with a bug of enthusiasm, or at least an appreciation for this wonderful gift. Thank you. To our inspirational and overall director extraordinaire, Jonathan Todd. Your vision and patience when all of us didn't have a clue what you were talking about. You have triumphed and inspired once again. Everything from your insistence that the columns moved to the fact that the pyramid had to be that big and had to be lit and that everything had to be lit. Bravo, Jonathan, bravo. To our parents and students, both on stage and in the audience. Thank you for your support. I hope you will take these past three nights with you and cherish them for years to come. I know I will. Thank you and good night.